Good morning to all of you. So today we are going to study hemodynamics of phallocytology. I've already taken topic of phallocytology. So you had doubts regarding hemodynamics of phallocytology. So this short video is attempt to answer this question, which had come in one of the question paper. Now, what do you mean by hemodynamics? Okay, hemodynamics, or this we can write it as HEMO or HAEMO, it means the same thing. So what it is? It is the dynamics of blood flow. Now, what do you mean by this? Dynamics of blood flow means how the blood is flowing from one area to the other. Or we are basically talking about, in phallocytology, we are basically talking about what are the changes in blood flow because of the different defects in it. Okay, so the study of blood flow is called as hemodynamics. Hemodynamics is also defined as, it is a branch of physiology that deals with circulation of blood. Okay, so this is hemodynamics. So our aspect of hemodynamics is hemodynamics in phallocytology. Okay, we know that in phallocytology we have different defects. Okay, first is there is stenosis of the pulmonary artery. Next is there is overriding of aorta. There is a large VST. Okay, and so different defects are there. So now what we are going to do is, and apart from that, we have right ventricular hypertrophy. So now we are going to study what is hemodynamics of phallocytology, which has four defects. First is pulmonary stenosis, ventricular septal defect. Third is overriding aorta, and fourth is right ventricular hypertrophy. Okay. Now, hemodynamics of tetralogy of phallets depends on, first is degree of right ventricular, that is RV, outflow tract obstruction. Okay. So that is the first issue, that is pulmonary. This is nothing but the pulmonary stenosis. Okay, we know that in from the right ventricle, the pulmonary artery arises. Okay, so pulmonary artery stenosis is there. To what degree stenosis is there? This will depend on the, so the hemodynamics of phallocytology depends on to what extent is stenosis present. If mild stenosis will be present, the flow will be different, and if it is too much of stenosis, then the effect is different. Okay, so flow hemodynamics of tetralogy depends on degree of right ventricular outflow tract obstruction. We know that the blood from the pulmonary artery causes the blood to go to the lungs. Okay, and if you have pulmonary artery stenosis, so here there will be stenosis at the starting point, so less blood will be flowing to the lungs, so naturally less blood will be coming back. So hemodynamics will be depend on, first is right ventricular outflow tract obstruction. Okay, second is ventricular septal defect is usually non-restrictive. Okay, non-restrictive means it doesn't restrict. Now what is the reason? In phallocytology, usually VST is quite large. Okay, it is quite large, and if you have a large VST, the restriction will be less. Okay, the if you have a small VST, the restriction will be more. That means it will allow the blood to flow through it through difficulty. Okay, but here what you have is usually a large VST. So we have a ventricular septal defect, and we know that ventricular septal defect is an abnormal hole which is present between the right atrium, right ventricle and the left ventricle. So this is non-restricted. Okay, so because it is non-restricted, so the amount of blood which is present in the right ventricle and the amount of blood which is present in the left ventricle almost becomes equal. Okay, so that is why what you have here is the right ventricular and left ventricular pressures are equalized. So if you if we can do cardiac catheterization, so what we find here is the right ventricular pressure and the left ventricular pressure are almost equalized. Why? Because of the large VST which is present. Okay. So this is an important part of tetralogy of Fallot. It depends on first is the to what extent is the pulmonary artery stenosis present. Is it less or is it more? Hemodynamics will depend on that. Next is the ventricular septal defect. It is usually a large defect. So the amount of blood which is present in right and left will become almost equal. And that is why we know that depending on the volume of blood, the pressure depends. Okay. So that is why the right ventricular and left ventricular pressures are equalized. Okay. I will explain you in one or two subsequent slides. So hemodynamics is blue TOF, that is tetralogy of Fallot's, and we have pink TOF. Okay. Blue TOF is, these are those babies with Fallot tetralogy who are blue even at rest. Okay. So these are those babies where the pulmonary artery stenosis is very severe. I would use the word marked. Okay. So blue TOF with marked sinusitis due to severe pulmonary stenosis. Okay. So that is why sinusitis, even when the baby is at rest, the baby will be sinused. And what happens in pink is the baby will be pink at rest, but will become sinused during activity or whenever the baby is crying. Okay. So the defects remain same. So one thing to remember in blue and pink TOF is pink babies also have those four defects. The blue babies also have that four defects. Now, what is the difference? Difference is in pulmonary stenosis, and this causes differences in sinusitis. Okay, so blue TOF is marked with severe pulmonary stenosis. So, if you have severe pulmonary stenosis, stenosis means narrowing. We have already discussed in Fallot's tetralogy. So what does it cause? This causes increased pressure in the right ventricle. Why? Because whatever blood which has been shifted from the right ventricle to the left ventricle, from the right atrium to the right ventricle, and from the right ventricle to the pulmonary artery, the blood is expected to flow to the lungs. But abhi problem yahan pe kya hai? Jo blood right atrium se right ventricle mein aa gaya hai, वहां से वो लंग्स में नहीं जा पा रहा, वो ब्लड वहां पे पूल अप हो गया. ओके, सो इससे दो चीजें होंगी. फर्स्ट इज देयर विल बी राइट वेंट्रिकुलर हाइपरट्रॉफी. क्यों राइट वेंट्रिकुलर हाइपरट्रॉफी? बिकॉज द राइट वेंट्रिकल विल ट्राई टू इंक्रीज द प्रेशर सो दैट सम हाउ द ब्लड इज शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम द राइट वेंट्रिकल इन टू द पल्मोनरी आर्टरी. तो ये ज्यादा प्रेशर बार बार करने के कारण there will be changes in musculature and this causes right ventricular hypertrophy. So, ye jab badhte chale jayega to dikkat kya hoga? Hypertrophied area will not be able to pump properly. So, as age advances, the problems becomes more severe. Second is, because there is the blood which is expected to go into the pulmonary artery, wo theek se nahi ja pa raha kyunki stenosis jyada hai. So, problem kya hoga? There will be right to left shunt through large BST. ठीक है? मैंने आपको बताया कि BST is bit large. Okay? So the amount of blood which is present in the right ventricle वो right to left shunt होगा. अगर आपको मेरा previous classes before lockdown, if you remember, I was talking to you about fetal circulation. We studied about ASD, BST, PDA. So in all those cases, there was left to right shunt. So there was no sinusitis. But here this is a this is the area of sinusitis where there is shunting from right to left. Right mein kaun sa blood hai? Deoxygenated blood hai. It is going to the left side. Kaise ja raha left side mein? Because wahan par ek bada VST hai. Okay? So, because through this blood which is going. Uska next problem kya hai? There is an overriding aorta. Humko malum hai, ye VST ke just upar ek overriding aorta hai. Jiska opening is on the right side as well as on the left side. To kya hoga? A mixed blood goes to all parts of the body, and whenever you have deoxygenated blood circulated to all parts of the body, there will be sinusitis. Okay, so this causes sinusitis at rest and during activity. Okay, I think it is clear. I will just revise it again. The major difference between blue and pink TOF is degree of pulmonary stenosis. जो हमने just अभी previous slide में पढ़ा, hemodynamics depends on on degree of pulmonary artery stenosis. Okay, so pulmonary artery stenosis in blue TOFS, there is marked sinusitis due to severe pulmonary artery stenosis. तो इससे क्या होगा, राइट वेंट्रिकल का प्रेशर बढ़ गया. ओके, क्यों राइट वेंट्रिकल का प्रेशर बढ़ गया, बिकॉज पल्मोनरी आर्टरी वहीं से स्टार्ट हो रहा है. ओके, इट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम देयर एंड द प्रेशर इंक्रीजेस बिकॉज द ब्लड विच इज प्रेजेंट इन द राइट वेंट्रिकल इज अनेबल टू गो इन टू द पल्मोनरी आर्टरी, सो द प्रेशर इंक्रीजेस. सो वेन द प्रेशर इंक्रीजेस दिस लीड्स टू राइट वेंट्रिकुलर हाइपरट्रॉफी. वाई, बिकॉज द राइट वेंट्रिकल ट्राइज इट्स लेवल बेस्ट उस ताकि किसी भी तरह प्रेशर बढ़ाकर द ब्लड विल गो. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज देयर इज अ राइट टू लेफ्ट शंट. देयर इज राइट टू लेफ्ट शंट बिकॉज ऑफ द बीएसटी. राइट से लेफ्ट क्यों हो रहा, क्योंकि यहाँ का प्रेशर भी बढ़ गया. ओके, इट इज नॉट लेफ्ट साइडेड प्रेशर. लेफ्ट में वी नो दैट आफ्टर बर्थ लेफ्ट का प्रेशर इज स्लाइटली हायर एज कम्पेयर टू राइट. पर अभी प्रॉब्लम यहाँ पे क्या है, बिकॉज ऑफ द पल्मोनरी आर्टरी स्टेनोसिस देयर इज पूलिंग ऑफ ब्लड, सो नेचुरली ब्लड फ्रॉम अ हायर प्रेशर एरिया will move to a lower pressure area. In that way, we have right to left shunt through a large BST. And we have an overriding aorta which has its opening both on the right side and the left side, and you have mixed blood circulated to all parts of the body. So this causes sinusitis at rest and as well as during activity. Okay. Next is pink TOF. The only difference is mild pulmonary stenosis. Rest everything remains same. Okay. Pink TOF with less sinusitis because of mild pulmonary stenosis. क्यों कम sinusitis है? Why? Because blood. देखो, one thing to remember is if you have less pulmonary stenosis, तो जो right ventricle में blood है, वो blood will go to the lungs. And when the lungs में कोई no congenital defect. So if the blood is going to the lungs, that blood will become oxygenated, and there is a better return of oxygenated blood. ठीक है? So that is why it is called as pink TOF. Pink TOF has less sinusitis as compared to blue TOF. The result is mild pulmonary stenosis. Blood jo hai, for example, blue TOF mein out of 100 ml, this is just an example, suppose out of 100 ml, 40 ml gaya, 60 ml raha gaya. But yahan pe it will be 80 ml is going and only 20 ml is remaining. Okay, so this might be the situation. So this is mild pulmonary stenosis. Okay, so isse kya hoga, there is we know that this there is less increase in pressure in the right ventricle. Blue ke hisab se yahan pe pressure kam hai. Okay, so right ventricular hypertrophy wo bhi reduce ho raha hai. Okay, and there is right to left shunt through large BST is less. There will be shunting 100%, but shunting, the amount of shunting will be less. Okay, kyunki jyada blood kahan chale gaya, lungs mein chale gaya. Overriding aorta carries a mixed blood, but the amount of deoxygenated blood will be less as compared to blue TOF. Okay, so this causes no sinusitis at rest. That is, baby is pink at rest and blue during crying and activity. Okay, yeah, I think it is clear. In pink TOF, the only difference is pulmonary artery stenosis is less. So once you have mild pulmonary stenosis, the result kya hai? Two things. One is more blood goes to the lungs. So when more blood is going to the lung, more blood will come back from the lungs. So finally, the availability of oxygenated blood is more as compared to blue. Second thing, right ventricular hypertrophy is less. Why? Because ज़्यादा pressure बढ़ाने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. थोड़ा सा stenosis है. So more of the blood is going. अब यहाँ का प्रेशर उतना नहीं बढ़ रहा एज कम्पेयर टू ब्लू ट्यूब. सो नेचुरली द शंटिंग राइट टू लेफ्ट शंट दैट इज ऑल्सो रिड्यूस. सो बिकॉज ऑफ ऑल दिस रीजन, इवन दो द ओवरराइडिंग एओर्टा इज कैरिंग अ मिक्स्ड ब्लड टू ऑल पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी, द रिजल्टेंट साइनोसिस इज रिड्यूस्ड. ओके, सो दिस कॉजेस नो साइनोसिस एट रेस्ट. दैट इज बेबी इज पिंक एट रेस्ट एंड ब्लू ड्यूरिंग क्राइंग एक्टिविटी. ओके, so that was all about hemodynamics of tetralogy of Fallot. I hope you have understood. Stay safe and thank you.